Hello, I am Matteo Piovella, President of Italian Ophthalmological Society and Medical Director of CMA Outpatient Surgery Center in Monza. The video you are about to watch is titled Percent Tissue Altered PTA, the story of its significant role as a risk factor for ectasia. 25 years ago, laser vision correction was introduced in eye care and produced a terrific wow effect worldwide. Palikaris and Buratto, to develop LASIK surgery, applied the knowledge coming from Barraquet's keratomyelosis, the perfect target were eye myopes patients. Due to that, in 1919, I have developed with Steve Trockel multi-zone technique for eye myopia treatment, and I was proud to present the result related to a minus 18 diopter treatment applied on an amblyopic eye. Today, we know that the perfect target for laser vision correction to avoid complication and loss of quality of vision are not eye myopes treatment. This video, edited by Marcony Santhagio, is a milestone to focus and understand the importance to detect preoperatively the right harmonization between the amount of the refractive defect to correct and the opportunity for the cornea to be efficient and to avoid huge complication as ectasia. And it is clear to everybody that the possibility to get complication and miss the perfect target is the main motivation for normal people to avoid to submit the refractive surgery. It tells you the whole story from the beginning and tries to finalize the goal to get the magic number related to the corneal bed thickness that for many years all the refractive surgeons were looking for. This research was like trying to understand the unicorn legend. But today, new data, practical experience, new technology application, and more knowledge have perfectly explained what was difficult to understand and accept at the time.
The authors have no financial interest in the subject matter of this film. While most patients who have developed ectasia after LASIK have had in retrospect identifiable risk factors that place them at a high risk for this complication, particularly irregular topographic patterns, ectasia cases in patients with normal preoperative topography still present a conundrum. Postoperative ectasia most likely represents a reduction in biomechanical integrity below the threshold required to maintain corneal shape and curvature. This could theoretically occur when a cornea already destined to manifest ectasia has surgery, which is the case of young patients who still develop the first detectable signs of keratoconus, a preoperatively weak but clinically stable cornea has surgery, which is the case of deformed frus keratoconus or suspicious topographic patterns, or when a relatively normal cornea is weakened below a safe threshold. As corneal tensile strain is not uniform throughout the central corneal stroma, with a progressive weakening in the posterior two-thirds, the relative extent of biomechanical alteration after refractive surgery, expressed as depth, definitely plays a role in postoperative weakening. Flap thickness factors directly into this alteration, as the anterior lamellar flap does not contribute significantly to postoperative corneal tensile strength. Based on these corneal structural differences, it seems logical that a ratio or percentage could provide more specific or individualized information than previous thickness values of total cornea or residual stromal bed, and that concept formed the basis of this new metric we are proposing. In each individual, there is an integrated relationship between preoperative corneal thickness, ablation depth, and flap thickness in determining the relative amount of biomechanical change that has occurred after LASIK procedure. We recently proposed the metric, the percent tissue altered, PTA, that we believe better describes this interaction. PTA is the combination of flap thickness plus ablation depth divided by preoperative central corneal thickness. We hypothesize that this metric may more accurately represent the risk of ectasia and the individual components that comprise it. After we analyze the impact of LASIK in normal eyes and find out PTA was the variable that correlates the most with change in biomechanical properties, we decided to specifically investigate the association of PTA with the occurrence of ectasia after LASIK for myopia in eyes with strictly normal preoperative placebo-disc-based corneal topography. When compared to the control group, comprised with eyes that underwent uncomplicated LASIK, the eyes that developed ectasia presented a significantly higher PTA value. Although PTA is a continuous variable, the ROC curve revealed a cutoff of 40% as the value with the maximized sum of sensitivity and specificity. Considering now only the eyes that develop ectasia, a PTA higher than 40% was by far the most prevalent risk factor, presenting 97% of the eyes. The odds ratio analysis revealed that the chance of ectasia occurring in LASIK eyes that present a PTA higher than 40% is 200 times higher than chance of ectasia in LASIK eyes with lower PTA values. If employed as a screening method, the PTA higher than 40 would generate a sensitivity of 97% and a negative predictive value of 95%. Our study highlights the relative extent of biomechanical alteration related to flap thickness and ablation depth. The blue line represents the patient's PTA, and the red line the PTA limit of 40%. A patient with corneal thickness of 540 microns, a flap thickness of 110, and an ablation depth of 60 microns would have a PTA of 31%, and this patient would be considered low risk in case he also had a normal topography. On the other hand, a patient with corneal thickness of 515 microns, a flap thickness of 135 and ablation depth of 90 microns would have a PTA of 44%, a value that would place this patient at higher risk for post-LASIK ectasia. The main explanation for our findings most likely lies in the relative percentage contribution of the anterior stroma to the total corneal strength, which is modified after excimer laser refractive surgery, derived from flap thickness creation and the ablation depth combined. Since the cohesive tensile strength is not uniform throughout the central corneal stroma and is greater in the anterior third, removing this relevant part of the stroma may induce corneal weakening in increasing proportion as the threshold of 40% is reached and crossed. As compared to specific cutoff values of residual stromal bed or corneal thickness, PTA likely provides a more individualized measure of biomechanical alteration because it considers in one metric the relationship between corneal thickness, tissue altered through ablation depth and flap creation, and ultimately residual stromal bed thickness. This is probably why absolute values and cutoff numbers of residual stromal bed or corneal thickness have historically failed in determining the high ectasia risk patients. There are many studies reporting ectasia in eyes where the safety limits for residual stromal bed were respected. Recently, Random et al. Published a paper about ectasia and showed that in eyes with normal topography, the mean values of corneal thickness and residual stromal bed were considered safe. Had PTA been calculated, the mean values would have been 43%, which according to our findings is enough to create ectasia. When analyzing different reports of ectasia in eyes that were considered low risk for this complication, each one of them put forward a different explanation for ectasia. All of them should be respected, and they are not mutually exclusive. However, all of them share one characteristic in common: they all have a PTA higher than 40%. It is very important to understand the concept of risk factor. The weakening predicted by either a high PTA or topographic irregularity or any other risk factor does not mean ectasia will occur in all high-risk eyes, merely that these eyes carry an increased risk for ectasia. Given the elective nature of LASIK, it seems logical that the balance of risk acceptance should be weighted towards minimizing risk. It seems logical that percent tissue alter will have different impact in screening eyes with suspicious topography, since those corneas are by definition already showing evidence of abnormal weakening prior to any ablation. In conclusion, the results of our study provide scientific evidence of the association of percent tissue alter with post-LASIK ectasia in eyes with normal corneal topography, and reveal that a PTA higher than 40% presented the highest predictive capability differentiating high-risk patients.